Check. Check. Dear members in the audience, a very good morning on this very windy morning. And I think I must compliment each one of you all to sit in spite of the elements that are out there to enjoy a very engaging session. My name is Tony Francis and I welcome you to the second day of the Bangalore Literary Festival. We shall begin with a fusion of Bharatanatyam classical singing and English renderation of Mahakavi Subramania Bharati's poetry. We have three performers here waiting for you, three wonderful individuals. An introduction of the first. She is a vocalist who started learning Carnatic music at a very young age and is a disciple of Srimati Neela Ramagopal, a performer at mega events and a teacher of dance to young children. Please welcome Geetha Srikrishnan. The second performer has been practicing and performing Bharatanatyam for the past 2.5 decades. She holds a master's degree in Bharatanatyam and its allied subjects such as philosophy, history, and subject and study of temple architecture. A teacher and a choreographer, her focus is on pursuing excellence in Bharatanatyam, exploring the various possibilities of the art form with conviction and adherence to its traditional richness and depth. Please welcome Ramaa Venugopal. And finally, a writer, translator, and environmentalist. She has won several prizes for writing, including 3 consecutively in the Commonwealth Short Story Competition. She authored A Bond So Sacred, Tracking Purnima, and Panchali's Pledge. Her other works include selected poems of Subramania Bharati. She is a founder, trustee, and chairperson of PNLIT, which nurtures the Putanahalli Lake in South Bangalore. Please welcome Usha Rajagopalan.
We'll start this program with an invocation.
Before you do, ma'am, I want to just reintroduce you because I mentioned you are a dancer. She's not. She is a musician. And as a favor to me, please another round of applause for this wonderful talent. The stage is over to you all. Thank you so much.
திருவை பணிந்து நித்தம் செம்மை தொழில் புரிந்து வருக வருவதென்றே கிளியே வருக வருவதென்றே கிளியே மகிழ்வுற்றிரு போமடி கிளியே மகிழ்வுற்றிரு போமடி கிளியே மகிழ்வுற்றிரு போமடி வெற்றி ஜெயலுக்குண்டு விதியின் நியமம் என்று கற்று தெளிந்த பின்னும் கிளியே கவலைப்படலாகுமோ துன்ப நினைவுகளும் சோர்வும் பயமும் எல்லாம் அன்பில் அழியுமடி கிளியே அன்பு கழிவில்லை கான் ஞாயிற்று எண்ணி என்றும் நடுமை நிலை பயின்று ஆயிரம் ஆண்டுலகில் கிளியே அழிவின்றி வாழ்வோமடி தூய பெருங்கனலை சுப்பிரமணியனை தூய பெருங்கனலை சுப்பிரமணியனை நேயத்துடன் பணிந்தால் கிளியே நேயத்துடன் பணிந்தால் கிளியே நெருங்கி துயர் வருமோ, கிளியே நெருங்கி துயர் வருமோ, கிளியே நெருங்கி துயர் வருமோ.
This is a song sung to a parrot. Praying to the Supreme and working diligently, heedless of what is in store for us, let us be happy. Destiny rules that tireless work will one day be rewarded. When we know this, little bird, why are we despondent? Love will erase thoughts of fear, fatigue, and all trials. Don't you know, feathered friend, that love is eternal? If we seek the blessing, little bird of the fiery sun, and live with no prejudice, we will live to be 1,000. If we pray to Subramania the pure, the heart of light, will any sorrow dare touch us, bird, or any blight? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming to our presentation today. In classical poetry, the poet very often used to address bird or the wind or elements. I'm sorry for these interruptions, some elements and some man-made, which is what we have to live with. And so as I was saying, in classical poetry, the poets very often addressed or sent messages through a swan or through the wind or through a bird, in this case a parrot. And it is not surprising that Bharati should have written this poem. It's called basically a kilipata. It has this very simple tune, a repetitive tune, which can catch on and be expressed very well, and that is what Geetha sang today. And Bharati was introduced to classical Tamil literature at a very, very young age. He lost his mother at the age of 5, and his father found it a little difficult to bring him up. So it was his grandfather who had a big hand in his upbringing. Bharati's grandfather, he exposed him to a classical Tamil literature. And for a child prodigy like Bharati, who saw nature, who saw music, who saw everything in nature around him, this was a godsend, because it was teaching him, it was introducing him to a world that is in the imagination and that goes beyond anything else. Bharati's father wanted him to learn well. He sent him to an English medium school where he wanted him to study English and arithmetic, grow up to become an engineer, earn lots and lots of money, and be happy ever after. But Bharati the boy, what he wanted to do was to look out of the window. He hated school, like many children, of course. But Bharati preferred to skip classes and sit near the river. He was brought up in a very small town called Ettayapuram in Tirunelveli district. So what he saw and he was one with was with nature. In the trilling and warbling of birds in the forest, in the music of the wind as it rustles through the leaves, in the laughter of the rippling river and cascading falls, in the ever-swelling waves of the blue ocean, in the passionate lyrics of girls deeply in love, in songs that drip with honey, in notes that melt the heart, in the sing-song of farmers as they draw water, in the ancient chants of women as they grind corn, in the country notes of those who powder limestone, in the catchy little ditties of women working in farms, in the tinkling of bangles on maidens' arms in a circle as they dance, clapping their hands, in the notes of the flute and the veenai, and in instruments that men strum or blow air through, in the melody that is heard all day long, in the teeming city and in nature's wilderness. In all these notes, I have lost myself. Bharati really had lost himself to the world of poetry. to the world of literature. And what he used to do was bunking classes, and of course being one with nature, he would also run away to the palace of the Maharaja of Ettayapuram for a very simple reason, because the Maharaja invited scholars and intellectuals and poets and writers, and they used to have these discussions, and Bharati used to sit, listen to them, and sometimes forget himself and burst out into poetry. It was at one such event at the assembly of scholars that he burst into poetry, and he was conferred with the title of Bharati. He was C. Subramaniam to begin with, and he was conferred with the title of Bharati, the one who is blessed. Was doing extremely well as a poet, but poetry never made the poet rich, neither then nor now. So he definitely wanted him to become a more responsible student working on his arithmetic and English, because he felt English is the way forward, and arithmetic because he can become an engineer. In order to instill a sense of responsibility in the boy, his father got him married at the age of 14. How old do you think his wife would have been at the time? Nearly 8 years old. And it was a wedding which lasted for several days. And Bharati being what he was, he enjoyed himself thoroughly. He sang love songs to his wife-to-be. And Chellamma was squirming in embarrassment, thinking, what kind of a person have I married? Am I getting married to? Because who would ever imagine, at a time, you must imagine, Bharati was born in 1882. Okay? And you can imagine how conservative the society was at that time. And for this young man to sing, a boy, really, 14 years as a boy, we would consider them a boy now. But he was getting married. And he sang love songs to his wife-to-be. And this poor thing was squirming in embarrassment. But later on, she was to realize what a genius of a man she had married. Now, if the father thought that by getting him married, he was going to make Bharati a more responsible person, he didn't live long enough to find out, because exactly a year after Bharati got married, his father died. And now, Bharati had to grow up in a hurry. He had to finish his education. He went to Banaras. He studied Hindi, Sanskrit, French, several languages, and there he saw Sardarji's the dress, and that's when he started wearing a turban. He started growing his beard, and he walked with a very straight back, upright, and looking straight into the eyes of the other. So Bharati came back. Of course, he had to come back. Now he had a wife to support, and also his stepmother and the siblings. He had to support them as well. He came back to Ettayapuram and he took up a job in the Maharaja's palace. What was his job was? He had to read out literature, the newspaper, to the Maharaja. Now a fiery, independent soul like Bharati is not going to like it one bit. Soon enough, he took up a temporary position as a teacher in a school. And that too was not really to his interest. Because now as a married man, and he had to assume some sense of responsibility, and what he wanted was a simple living. But at the same time, his father died because his father incidentally had a ginning factory in Ettayapuram, and he tried all sorts of technological innovations and everything failed. And it was more because of a broken heart that his ginning factory didn't do well that Bharati's father died, rather than the son becoming not responsible enough. So ever since his father died trying to make money, Bharati had decided he is not going to hanker after money. Money will come if it has to come. But that didn't stop Bharati from saying, Kani Nilam Vendum Parashakti, Kani Nilam Vendum. a patch of land I want, Parashakti. Give me a patch of land. On that patch of land, Parashakti, I want a house built for me. Its pillars decorated, Parashakti, and balconies painted white. Palm trees beside the well, Parashakti, with long fronds and tender nuts, 10 or 12. Those palms, Parashakti, the coconut trees, I want nearby. Moonlight should descend gently, Parashakti, casting a gleaming veil of white. The soft cooing of the cuckoo, Parashakti, should fall lightly on my ears. A gentle breeze should blow, Parashakti, and bring pleasure to my soul. A young wife I want, Parashakti, to share all these with me. A joyful togetherness, Parashakti, blessed with poetry. Living in that open land, Parashakti, be there to guard us. With the power of my songs, Parashakti, enable me to defend this earth. Now, Geetha and Rama will execute this to song and dance.
Parashakti, Parashakti, Kani Nilam Vendum, Parashakti, Kani Nilam Vendum, Kani Nilam Vendum, Parashakti, Kani Nilam Vendum. அந்த காணி நிலத்திடையே ஓர் மாளிகை கட்டித்தர வேண்டும். 10-12 தென்னை மரம் பக்கத்திலே வேண்டும். நல்ல முத்துச்சுடர் போலே நிலா ஒளி முன்பு வர வேணும். கத்தும் குயிலோ செய்யி சற்று வந்து காதிற்பட வேணும். அங்கு கத்தும் குயிலோ செய்யி சற்று வந்து காதிற்பட வேணும். என்ற சித்தம் மகிழ்ந்திடவே நன்றாயிளம் தென்றல் வர வேணும். சித்தம் மகிழ்ந்திடவே நன்றாயிளம் தென்றல் வர வேணும். காட்டு வெளியினிலே காட்டு வெளியினிலே அம்மா நின்றன் காவலுற வேணும். காட்டு வெளியினிலே அம்மா நின்றன் காவலுற வேணும். என்றன் பாட்டு திறத்தாலே யுவையத்தை பாலித்திட வேணும். என்றன் பாட்டு திறத்தாலே யுவையத்தை பாலித்திட வேணும். காணி நிலம் வேண்டும் பராசக்தி, காணி நிலம் வேண்டும், காணி நிலம் வேண்டும் பராசக்தி, காணி நிலம் வேண்டும்.
In order to earn a livelihood, Bharatiya joined Swadesa Mitran as the assistant editor. That was a wonderful opportunity for Bharati, not just to get his own works published, but because one of the things he had to do was to translate the speeches made by Gandhiji, other political leaders, into Tamil. And he adopted a language which was absolutely simple, used by the common man, and it reached the common man on the street. That was a huge influence on his writing style. It is not as if people didn't adopt a simple style earlier, but Bharati was one who really popularized it. And he not only stopped with writing in the style in just a political commentary, but also in his own poetry. That is why you find his poems comparatively simple. And it caused 20th century Tamil literature to be called the Age of Bharati. Now, at Swadesamitran, he was, of course, publishing his own works. And he was also being a very fiery congressman. He was writing quite a lot of writing which did not win pleasure from the British. And his wife did not like it one bit, because already he was not earning much, and the Swadesamitran itself refused to publish his editorials because it was too fiery for them and they had to run the paper. Bharati, in order to appease Chellamma, she had recognized what a genius her husband was, and in order to appease her, quite often he had used her as the inspiration. And this is one particular poem which I think is really the most romantic poems. It is called Kannamma and Kadali. Even though her name is Chellamma, quite often he addressed the poem to Kannamma, though he meant Chellamma. Now this one is Payum Oli Nee Enakku. All embracing radiance you are to me. I am the eyes that help you see. You are the dripping nectar from the honeycomb. I am your foraging bee. So innumerable are your virtues, I have no words to describe them. Kannamma, my precious, you are the glow from the vault of heaven. You are the veenai to me. I am the finger that strums the tuned string. You are the pendant adorning my neck. I am your new diamond sparkling. Wherever I look, what do I see but the blazing luster of your regal eye? Your esteemed highness, my queen, you are the bedrock of my life. You are the pouring rain to me. I am the dancing peacock to you. You are the thirst-quenching drink. I am the cup that holds it to you. You glow with the light of knowledge. Your face reveals its power. Your beauty is so flawless, Kannamma, it makes my mouth water. You are the light of the full moon. I am the sea surging to you. You are the perfect key in music. I am the melody of the tune. Intensely, though I think, no one thought can capture you fully. The vision of my eyes, Kannamma, you are so lovely. You are the fragrance wafting everywhere. I am the blooming flower. You are the meaning of my words from your lips, a speech I shower. Shining stars so full of love, how do I tell your beauty in words? My divine being, you are a blend of qualities of such high worth. You are the love of my life. I am the luring force of attraction. You are the wisdom behind everything. I am the cause of action. In the state of enlightenment, you are the sweet taste of bliss. You, the unheard song, you are the embodiment of goodness. You are sound health to me. I am the steadiness of your heartbeat. You are my bounty, my wealth. I am the notes kept for a future need. With your everlasting looks, you are the golden light that fills the void. With a smile like scented jasmine, you are the very pinnacle of joy. You are the lodestar in the sky, and I'm the cool moon to you. You are the acme of bravery. I'm the thrill of success to you. If on earth the pure pleasures of heaven you personify, my beloved, you are the elixir sweetening my mind.
Na na na
If Bharati had continued to write only poems like this, he would not have gotten into so much of trouble. But he was also such a fervent nationalist. He, ever since he joined Swadesa Mitran, he had lots of opportunities to and cover not only the speeches, but also attend a lot of conferences. He attended the Indian National Congress meeting at Calcutta, then in Surat. He met the leaders of the Indian struggle, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Gokhale, so many people. In 1908, he brought out his first book of poetry called Swadesa Geethangal, Songs of Freedom. So you can imagine what kind of songs it would have been. And the British had already, they had their antenna on the high about Bharati's writing. So one after the other, they were arresting the troublemakers, and Bharati was definitely one of the leading troublemakers. So he was advised by his friends, look, don't hang around in British India, you leave for Pondicherry. So much against his will, Bharati became a political fugitive in Pondicherry. He went in 1908, he was to spend the next 10 years there. And his family, already in deep financial trouble, came into bigger hardships then, because his only source of income, as the assistant editor of Swadesa Mitran, had also died. But for the poet, it was about the best time of his life. He came out with some magnificent work, and which also induced, told the British, come on, I'm still alive and kicking. And to the Indians back in India, come hither, come here, you with eyes bright and sparkling. Come hither, come you with hearts never wavering. Come hither, come here, you whose words are sweet to hear. Come hither, come here, you who are strong of shoulder. Come hither, come here, you whose thoughts have clarity. Come hither, come here, you who cannot endure the nasty. Come hither, come here, you who show pity for the destitute. Come hither, come here, you who walk like a bull well built. Come hither, come here, you who take as sacred all such writings which are true and honest. Come hither, come here, you who hate falsehood and burn to ash the tomes that foster the untruth. Come hither, come here, you whose mind is healthy. You are welcome too, who are strong in your body. Come hither, come here, you who have come as a savior to rescue our land of the terrible curse she has to endure.
களிபடைத்த மொழியினாய் வா வா வா, கருணை கொண்ட தோழினாய் வா வா வா. களிபடைத்த மொழியினாய் வா வா வா, கருணை கொண்ட தோழினாய் வா வா வா. தெளிவு பெற்ற மதியினாய் வா வா வா, சிறுமை கண்டு பொங்குவாய் வா. Ball nadai உதய ஞாயிறொப்பவே வா வா வா.
The British is not going to keep quiet. And they tried all the best to get Bharati to cross over the border so that they could arrest him. So one day, a man came to their house. Bharati, incidentally, he may be a genius, but he was also a terribly short-tempered man. And his wife and children, he had two daughters, they were pretty scared of him. And they could not question him about anything. So this man came to the house and Bharati took him upstairs and he had a very long talk with him. And without telling his wife where he was going, Bharati left with this man. Chellamma couldn't ask him, where are you going? When will you be back? Will you come home for a meal at least? Not that there is anything much to eat, but still whatever there is, we could share. So she waited and waited. The hours passed by and it was night. And Bharati came back with someone else. That person, he told Chellamma, look, the man who had come to meet Bharati was a British informer. He had told Bharati, the arrest warrant against you has been lifted. So you are now free to go back to India. Bharati, he believed the best in people. He believed him. And he was going back. And fortunately, at the border, this friend who brought him back, he saw this vehicle going with Bharati sitting in it and this political informer. So he stopped the vehicle and asked him, where are you going? Come back. No, the arrest warrant is very much there. You're going to get arrested. Come back. So he told him this. A few days later, this political informer came to their house once again. Chellamma is more of a human being than Bharati. He talked to him very nicely. That man fell at his feet and asked for forgiveness. And Bharati, the large-hearted soul that he was, forgave him on the spot. But not so Chellamma. Her face became absolutely red with fury. Seeing her so, so angry, Bharati sang a song to her on the spot. As somebody who writes poetry myself, I wish I could write poetry like this on the spot. Really, I can't say, but salute to you, Bharati. This one is called Pagaivan Karulvai Nannanche. So sorry, it is very windy and it's slightly tough. So please bear with me. This is, again, Geetha is not going to sing. It's me going to recite the English and Ramaa is going to dance. It's called Show Mercy to the Enemy. Show mercy to the enemy, kindly heart. Show mercy to the enemy. Show mercy to the enemy, kindly heart. Show mercy to the enemy. In the thick of smoke, in the thick of smoke, there is fire. In the thick of smoke, there is fire. We have seen this, kindly heart. We have seen this. In the midst of enmity, in the midst of enmity, God dwells His love. God dwells His love, kindly heart. God dwells His love. Show mercy to the enemy, kindly heart. Show mercy to the enemy. A lucent pearl can be found nestled. A lucent pearl can be found nestled within an oyster shell. Don't you know this, kindly heart? Don't you know this? Growing in the midst of refuse, growing in the midst of refuse, can't the Madhavi creeper bloom in profusion? Can't the Madhavi creeper bloom in profusion, kindly heart? Show mercy to the enemy, kindly heart. Show mercy to the enemy. When falsehood creeps into the mind, when falsehood creeps into the mind, can the mind be at peace, kindly heart? Can the mind be at peace? If but a little poison is added to pure honey, can it still be called honey, kindly heart? Can it still be called honey? Show mercy to the enemy, kindly heart. Show mercy to the enemy. To subdue another. To subdue another is to take one's own life. To subdue another is to take one's own life. Haven't you heard this, kindly heart? Haven't you heard this? Show mercy to the enemy, kindly heart. Show mercy to the enemy. At Pondicherry, some of the best works, important works of Bharati that he had ever written were written in that, particularly in 1 year, in 1912. And that year he wrote Kannan Paattu, Kuil Paattu, and of course Panchali Savanam. Kannan Paattu is a set of 23 lyrics where he has talked about Bhagavan Sri Krishna as servant, disciple, God, Kannan, Kannamma. And this is a poem, I'm sure many of you would have heard this. Kaattile Theduthal, Dikku Theriyatha Kaattil. I must also bring in a little bit of my experience with this. When I was translating this poem, every time I could see a dancer. And I am so glad that Ramaa is doing this. She is expressing in dance which I have visualized in my mind. So thank you so much, Ramaa, and thank you, Geetha, for this. Really, sincere thanks to both of you. This is titled Kannan and Kadalan. Kannan, my lover, searching for him. Dikku theriyatha kaattil unnai thedi thedi ilaithene. Roaming in a trackless dense forest, I grew so weary searching for you. Tall trees looming all around, fruits rich and exotic. Bamboo groves obstructing my view, rippling rivers gliding and snaking in a trackless, dense forest. Radiant flowers that ignite passion, a sea of leaves as far as eyes can see. The bewildering crisscross of springs, thick, menacing bushes bearing thorns in a trackless, dense forest. Deer with large, endearing eyes, tigers roaring, raising fear in my heart. Birds singing songs of love, lazy snakes stretching their sinuous length in a trackless dense forest. The royal lion prowling fearlessly, the elephant trembling at its roar. The timid fawn fleeing quickly, the wise frog eluding their rushing feet in a trackless dense forest. Tired to the bone, I swayed and stumbled, my eyes closed in desperate exhaustion, when staring at me brazenly stood a hunter, spear in hand, in a trackless dense forest. How ravishing you are, he leered. Girl, you're driving me mad. My dearest darling, how I desire to embrace you, he said, the wild-eyed hunter ripping my soul apart with his gleaming eyes. Stepping away, my hands together, I spoke thus to the cruel hunter. I fall at your feet, my brother. Please don't frighten me. Is it right to even look at one who's already married? You, don't preach to me, he said. I want only you, my pretty nymph. I am reeling under your spell as if intoxicated on some potent old wine. As soon as I heard these words, Kanna, I screamed and swooned, and in no time it seemed I opened my eyes to see you before me. Where is he, dear Kanna, that hunter? When he saw you, did he quake and grow pale? You answered my desperate plea like a savior. You came to redeem me. Don't we want to say a savior like this all the more now in these present days? This is a song. I'm sorry, apparently we are falling short of time, so we have been given just 5 minutes. I'm so sorry you're going to miss this opportunity to see Ramaa dance. And I will quickly wrap up this. We have been given just another 5 minutes. I would like to squeeze in at least one song or two. So Bharati came back to Madras. He crossed the border at Kadalur, and promptly he was arrested and put in jail. And his friends bailed him out. And he lived in Ettayapuram in his wife's parents' place. And he hated it. He obviously hated it. And then he moved back to Chennai, to Madras, and to spend the last days of his life there. He wasn't to know that. And he lived in a house near the Parthasarathi temple. He was in the habit of giving a banana to the temple elephant. And on that fateful day, his friends told him not to do that. The elephant is in must, so he wasn't to go near the elephant. But being Bharati that he is, he went to the elephant and he tried to feed the elephant. The animal was in must and it snatched Bharati and threw him down, and it would have stamped him to death. But for the fact that a friend of Bharati's who happened to be nearby, a very short man, Kuvalai Kannan, he literally pulled him out from beneath the elephant's feet. Years of deprivation, mental stress and hunger took their toll on Bharati. And on September 11th, 1921, Bharati passed away. In his lifetime, he had found it very difficult to publish his poetry. But in 1949, the government of Madras, they bought the copyright from his family and donated it to the public. Anybody can publish his works and anybody can translate. But the takeaway for us is the foresight, the relevance, the poet's work stand even today. And especially at a time when Chennai is reeling with rain, this is how the poet has expressed the power of rain. Exploding the 8 boundaries of space, takadim, tarikitadim, tarikitadim, tarikita, cracking the rugged mountains, the rain hurtles, 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 dam, tarikita, takatadingida, tittom, the earth tills, 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 the wind blows like one possessed, takadham, tarikitadham, tarikitadham, lightning slashes the air, bold waves slam against the sky, clouds thunder, the howling wind drills into the blue yonder. Chada 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 tata. The sky rumbles steadily. The entire space crumbles. Where did this rain come from, brother? Asked the poet then. And I am sure all of us are asking this now in Chennai. Where is this rain coming from? Our heart should go out to them because it was a misfortune that they happened to be living in Chennai. This was a disaster that could have happened very well in any city, including our own Bengaluru. As a lake conservationist, I know the importance of nurturing lakes, but this was a rain which was beyond all that. And it is still threatening to rain. I would appeal to all of you to please help out Chennaiites in whatever way you can. And finally, we would like to end this program with what Bharati wanted for people and what we want for everybody here. May our minds be firm, speech pleasant and thoughts pure. May we grasp the attainable. May our dreams come true. May we reap quickly the fruits of our effort. May we earn wealth and joy, fame on earth. May our eyes open, steady be our labor. May our women be unfettered, a fertile land, a heaven on earth. May truth prevail. May the Almighty God guard us all. Om, Om, Om.
Dikkal yettum chidari. Dikkal yettum chidari. Takadhim tarikida dhim tarikida dhim tarikida dhim tarikida dikkal yettum chidari. தக்க தீம் தரிக்கிட தீம் தரிக்கிட தீம் தரிக்கிட தீம் தரிக்கிட திக்கு எட்டும் சிதறே சிதறே பக்க மலைகள் உடைந்து வெள்ளம் பாயுது 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 பக்க மலைகள் உடைந்து வெள்ளம் பாயுது 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 தாம் தரிக்கிடத்தக்க ததுங்கின தோம் தித்தோம் அண்டம் சாயுது 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 தாம் தரிக்கிடத்தக்க ததுங்கின தோம் தித்தோம் அண்டம் சாயுது 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 பே கொண்டு தக்கை அடிக்குது காற்று பே கொண்டு தக்கை அடிக்குது காற்று தாம் தருகிட தாம் தருகிட தாம் தருகிட தாம் தருகிட திக்குக்கள் எட்டும் சிதறே சிதறே இடிக்குது மின்னல் கடல் வீர திரை கொண்டு விண்ணை இடிக்குது வெட்டி இடிக்குது மின்னல் கடல் வீர திரை கொண்டு விண்ணை இடிக்குது கொட்டி இடிக்குது மேகம் கூக்கூவென்று விண்ணை குடையுது காற்று கொட்டி இடிக்குது மேகம் கூக்கூவென்று விண்ணை குடையுது காற்று சட்டச்சட சட்டடடா என்று தாளம் கொட்டி கணக்கிது வானம் சட்டச்சட சட்டடடா என்று தாளம் கொட்டி கணக்கிது வானம் எட்டு திசையும் இடிய எட்டு திசையும் இடிய மழை எங்கனம் வந்ததடா மனதில் உறுதி வேண்டும் மனதில் உறுதி வேண்டும் வாக்கினிலே இனிமை வேண்டும் மனதில் உறுதி வேண்டும் வாக்கினிலே இனிமை வேண்டும் நினைவு நல்லது வேண்டும் நெருங்கின பொருள் கைப்பட வேண்டும் மனதில் உறுதி வேண்டும் கண் திறந்திட வேண்டும் காரியத்தில் உறுதி வேண்டும் கண் திறந்திட வேண்டும் காரியத்தில் உறுதி வேண்டும் பெண் விடுதலை வேண்டும் பெரிய கடவுள் காக்க வேண்டும் மண்பயனுற வேண்டும் மண் பயனுற வேண்டும் வானகம் இங்கு தென்பட வேண்டும் திசா பனி மாப்பா கமா வானகம் இங்கு தென்பட வேண்டும் உண்மை நின்றிட வேண்டும் உண்மை நின்றிட வேண்டும் உண்மை நின்றிட வேண்டும் ஓம் ஓம் ஓம்
ரவுண்ட் தேங்க் யூ செக் செக் செக்